In this video, I'm gonna show you how I took these photos and I'm gonna give you my 5 best tips for freehand insect macro photography. So let's go! My first tip, early mornings. They are so great because when I go up early in the morning to do insect photography, the insects have just started to move around, but they are still quite slow, so it's very easy to catch them compared to midday. And you don't need to go out like 3 or 4 a.m. At this particular morning I went out at 6 a.m. and that was just about right. The sun had been up for a couple of hours, but still the insects move a little more slowly. Another great thing with going out early in the morning is that you will be alone outside. There will be no other people, so it will be very quiet and peaceful, and you will find it a lot easier to focus. Which leads me to my next point: slow down. When you go out to do macro photography, I found it really important to begin by mentally slowing down. Just stand still for a while in front of a plant or whatever, and start looking for movement. Look for insects, look for anything small that moves around. You need to get out of your normal tempo where you just walk past plants and trees and stuff without noticing stuff. Because when you stand still for a little while, you will start noticing a lot of movement. So you kind of just need to go into this slower mind state. And when you're there, and when you found something to photograph, then my third tip is to keep the camera fixed while you move the branch that the insect is sitting on. I found that this makes it a lot easier to focus, especially when you're doing high magnification macro photography, as I'm doing here. This ant I filmed in more than 2x magnification, and thanks to moving the surface that the ant was sitting on instead of moving the camera, I was able to catch it. When you just move the camera and you let the plant be, if there is just a little bit of wind, it will be extremely hard to get the focus in the right place. And also the wind will of course make it harder to get a sharp photo. So hold the branch that the insect is sitting on and try to adjust it to the right position to get the best focus. Number 4. Only spend time with willing models. What do I mean by this? What I mean is that most insects are extremely skittish. As soon as you approach them with your camera, they will fly away or jump away or creep away. As you saw right here, the butterfly I tried to photograph was gone before I even noticed it. And 90% of all insects that you encounter will behave like this, and that's fine, that's how it is. What you should try to do is to just move on quickly when something is moving too fast and try to find your next model. Because around 10% of your subjects, your models, will be a little bit more cooperative. You will find that insect, that ant, or that butterfly, or that mosquito that stays around for a while, and that is when you have the chance to actually get a great photo. Because with an individual that just sits still and doesn't move away when you take 10, 20 or 30 photos, that is when you can actually do a great composition, you can find the right focus, you can find the right angle, and you can really make a good photograph. With an insect that just flies away within the first 5 seconds of you noticing it, it will be pretty much impossible to take a really good photo of that insect, unless you're extremely lucky. So try to find those 10% of insects that cooperate with you and stick around, take a lot of pictures. Sometimes you need to do some sacrifice to get your model to be still, but it can be worth it. And try to find the right model that is willing to cooperate, and you will get a lot more nice macro photos. By the way, if you're interested in what kind of equipment I use, in this video all the photos were taken with my home-built super macro rig, which gives a magnification of around 2.5x. And I use a Sony a7 III camera, which I really love. If you want to build this rig yourself, I made a video about it a year ago. Go check that video in case you want a similar setup yourself. It works also on Canon cameras. In case you're a bit more lazy and want to pick up macro photography, I would recommend you to start with a normal 1-to-1 magnification macro lens, just to learn the basics of how to do macro photography. And when you feel ready for it, I would really encourage you to buy a super macro lens, a lens with larger magnification. One of the best value for money super macro lenses that's out there right now is the Venus Optics 2x magnification 60mm macro lens. That's a great one. And you also have the Canon MP65, which is a lot more expensive. Tip number 5. Try a slower shutter speed. It's actually quite amazing how slow shutter speeds you can get away with when you're using a flash for your macro photos. And using a flash is pretty much a must if you want to take any decent looking macro photos, especially when doing high magnification macro photography. And with a slower shutter speed, such as 1/20th here, you see that you can get a lot more color from the background to shine through. And you might wonder, why isn't the image completely blurry when you're doing a 2x macro photo with 1/20th in shutter speed? And the answer is that the flash is sitting so close to the subject, on my rig at least, so that it can be extremely fast and capture and freeze the insect, even though the shutter speed is so much more slower. So I don't know exactly how fast the flash is, but I would bet that it is close to 1/1000th of a second or something like that. And that's enough to freeze the subject. And I actually noticed afterwards in this picture, if you look to the left, down to the left, you have two extremely small creatures. They must be a lot less than 1mm. And this is really one of the joys with high magnification macro photography, that sometimes afterwards you notice creatures that are a lot smaller than the very small creature you tried to photograph from the beginning. Anyways, I think that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like. And please subscribe if you want to see more of my photography videos. I'll be back very soon again with new explorations within the wonderful field of photography. See you soon, over and out.